A family in Ruiru has been plunged into mourning after their son, who is a KCSE candidate, was murdered and his badly mutilated body dumped in a swamp near their home. The boy's mother said the deceased went missing last Saturday after allegedly having an altercation with a woman who accused him of stealing her daughter's phone. And Embu Senator Lenny Kivuti has cautioned area residents to desist from illegal electricity connections. Kivuti was speaking in Embu Town while condoling with families whose homes were gutted down by a fire.
Mambo ya moto saingine unakuta watoto wanalemewa ndani kwa sababu ya moshi. Tushukuru Mungu kwa sababu hakuna mtoto aliumia. Sote suko hai. Na the only problem is only how to rehabilitate those people who are afflicted. Labda kama ni moto imeletwa na stima imewekwa wrong connection, mimi nitawasihi. Najua si watu wote wanaweza kuwa na nyumba kubwa. Sivyo? Lakini mkiweka stima, muwe mnaushisha Kenya Power.
Elsewhere, the Kenya Wildlife Service will spend over 2 million shillings in ground and air operations at Tsavo West and East National Parks to drive out 60,000 herds of cattle that are said to be grazing in the park over the last 1 month. Tsavo Conservation Assistant Director Joshua Chemtei says the move has since displaced most of the wild animals from the affected regions and is bound to cause further human wildlife conflict. Meanwhile, police in Kitale are holding a man suspected of killing his own brother. The suspect, Wycliffe Karanja, surrendered himself to the police and confessed to murdering his own brother, who had been missing for 3 weeks. He will be arraigned in court when police conclude investigations into the matter. Finally, Nakuru Children's Court has become the first court in the country to use video link when hearing testimonies. The move is aimed at protecting victims of defilement by enabling them to give testimonies from undisclosed and safe locations. Senior resident magistrate Judy Castan Doku expressed confidence that minors will now be able to give testimonies without undue intimidation. Mary Mwoki for Channel One News Hour.